All of this happened in the sister cities of Midland and Odessa. Nerves were already raw in Texas, where just 4 weeks ago, less than 300 miles away, a gunman opened fire at an El Paso Walmart, killing 22 people. You can hear nervousness in Alex Woods' voice as he recorded the end of the chase on his camera.
There's a shooting going on in Odessa, Texas. Oh God, they're shooting right there. Oh, he hits the barrier. The cop just hit the barrier.
Get out.
Stand still. He's shooting him. Oh, he killed him.
Man, there's a shooting. You watched the shooting happen.
Oh, he's shooting him up. He hit the barrier.
With us now on the line from Odessa, Texas, is the man who recorded those incredible images, Alex Woods. So, Alex, thank you for being with us.
Yeah, no problem.
This has been a harrowing day for you and another awful day for the people of Texas. So, first up, how are you? Are you doing okay?
Yeah, I'm still a little shook up. You know, I'm just trying to wrap my mind around this because I never thought I would witness it.
And this is a whole lot worse because, you know, but just 4 weeks ago, there's a mass shooting in El Paso, Texas. So have you been able to process this? Have you taken a moment to think all of this through?
Yeah, it's just, I'm still a little confused why it happened. Like, I know they had the one in El Paso, but I just never thought it would happen here. I mean, it's a pretty calm town. There's a lot of people and all, but it just seems very unreal.
Yeah, very, very unreal indeed. Look, what really struck me, though, is how quickly you reacted to what was happening right there in front of you. I want to play just the first few seconds of your video, which we have. Listen to this.
There's a shooting going on in Odessa, Texas. Oh, God, they're shooting right there. Oh, he hits the barrier. The cop just hit the barrier. Get out.
There seems to be no doubt, no hesitation. You know, you just jump into action. So can you explain, where did that clarity of thought come from?
From there, it was just all adrenaline. Just my brain wasn't really thinking. It was just saying, get it on camera because people need to see what is happening. And plus, I would like to hand this footage over to the police. Maybe it would help in their investigation.
And when you look at the video, it appears, you know, that there's quite some distance between you and then the police and the gunman, but, you know, often camera phones can be deceptive. You know, in reality, how close were you? And, you know, in particular, could you see the final moments when the police opened fire on the gunman?
Oh, yeah. In the video, when I, it's hard to see it, but when I said the police officer hit the barrier, it hit the mail van that was driving, and then he hit the barrier. And in that moment, the police officer jumped out of his vehicle and discharged his weapon into the driver's side of the mail van. And in that moment, I believe that was when the shooter was killed because there was no more shooting and it was a silence over there. It's not shown in the video, but SWAT did show up and they threw a flash grenade into the back of the van. I was assuming they did that to make sure there were no further threats hiding in there.
Yeah. So that officer, he was in his vehicle, there was someone driving, and he got out? And, you know, was he sort of just this sort of regular garden variety police officer? You know, he wasn't from some sort of tactical team. He wasn't wearing Kevlar, for example. He was just sort of a regular cop who drew his sidearm. Is that how you saw it?
Yeah, that's correct. He was, he might have been highway patrol. He was not like a, you know, like a SWAT or anything. He just rammed into that mail van, and that mail van spun around, and he jumped out of his vehicle and eliminated the threat.
And just with his regular sort of police issue,
yeah,
sidearm,
yeah, pistol.
When you consider everything that this guy who was driving, you know, this mail van had done, you know, the last couple of hours, the number of people he killed and wounded, this cop was, you know, incredibly brave.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we'd like to thank the first responders for the way they addressed the situation.
Yeah.
They put their lives on the line, and this cop was very brave for just jumping out of his vehicle and going straight to the threat to eliminate it, to save lives.
And we'd like to thank you, Alex, for capturing those images for us as well to see those final moments, because as we say, it's important that everyone gets to see how this all played out in the end, and we thank you for that. Alex, thank you.
Yeah, no problem.